there is no way that I could do 7 iron 185 carry with that kind of compression without a solid grip. Now, there are 5 ways I'm going to show you how to guarantee a proper top hand grip. This is one of the things that I see the most in the industry when I'm walking down the range or I have a new student that comes through my door. This is where there is such a lack of understanding in the functionality of the grip. So you really don't want to miss this show. A little word before we start. Please consider subscribing to our channel. Leave a comment or a question down below and hit that notification bell to make sure that you don't miss any future videos. Information like this kind of wisdom takes a lifetime to accumulate, and it could really give you a leg up on your competition and shortcut your learning process by decades, literally, okay? Now have a look at my son Riley. He is now Quebec champion. And you know, you got to hang on to these handlebars when you're BMX racing. If you've never seen BMX racing, it's an Olympic sport since 2008. Riley is now number 1 in Quebec. He's Quebec champion and number 5 in Canada. You got to hang on to your handlebars when it comes to stuff like that. Look at how he's holding on. So you got your handlebars here. Notice how the forearm and the handlebars are at a straight 90 degree angle, okay, or very similar to that. And if you look at this angle, notice how if we were to open the hand, how the heel pad of the hand is on top. So when he's pushing down on his bike and supporting his body weight with that, you got to be able to secure that heel pad on top. You can't be holding on to the bike through the center of the hand this way like so many of you do. How do you get into that predicament? Well, you put the sole of the club flat to the ground, and what ends up happening is now the angle of the club is way too upright. And now you try to grip it around that angle. This is absolutely crazy. Because there's no way that you're going to be able to wrap your hand around this. Look at the big gaping hole that you have in here now. So when I'm trying to hinge up and down from there, the extra force is going to have that club rub all over your glove, and you're going to open up big gaping holes here. This glove is well over a month in use, and I wear gloves every day. I hit golf balls every day. So notice there's no wear on this glove. That's because when I hold it like my handlebars this way, notice I can hinge up and down and nothing is coming apart. Everything is vacuum sealed and airtight. So now I have a veritable compression chamber right here. Want another one? For all you baseball players out there. If I'm holding my baseball bat waiting for my pitch, I'm not going to hold it like this, right? It's not going to go very far, and it'll probably get knocked out of my hands. This is where you hold that baseball bat, don't you? Then you put the other hand on top. Notice how everything comes. Now I can wait for my pitch. There's where impact's gonna be. And then there's gonna be a nice release of that action. So this feels like I've got really good support to have that ball rocket off that face or rocket off the bat. Okay? So this is how you would hold it. Now, once you've got that grip on the baseball bat, all you got to do is put your thumb on top, and that's it. So we got a nice grip, thumb on top, and we're done. notice we got the same thing. You want to play while it's raining and it's very windy? Well, this is how you're going to hold the umbrella, correct? If you don't hold the umbrella like that, if you hold the umbrella the same way as you're holding your golf club, you're going to get wet. Here it is. Thumb on top. Simple. Now, if you're traveling with a suitcase, well, look at this. If I wanted to carry this bag, I'm going to put my fingers underneath the handle and bring the handle to the heel pad of my hand. See this? Fingers, and then I bring it to the heel pad of the hand. Now I can really support something very heavy. So notice the fingers are supporting on the other side. So I know many of you are saying, well, is this more in the fingers or is it more in the palm? I call it the hand. So if you're using your hand properly to take the club, what you're looking for is pressure, the ability to create pressure. So imagine this was a hose, and I'm going to hold this hose in a way that I'm going to clamp down and cut off the circulation. There it is. Last one. Hey, if I'm in the gym and I want to do some push-ups while I'm holding golf clubs, this is the only way to go. Notice I'm right on my knuckles. It feels very, very solid. Now I can go ahead and do some push-ups. Notice where I'm holding that club. Exactly in the same place as I'm holding my handlebars, holding my club. That's it. So now I've got a grip. Notice where I'm grabbing it from. I'm not gonna ground my club or sole my club. I'm going to take my umbrella, or I'm going to take my baseball bat, or I'm going to get it onto my bike. And now notice how the toe of the club is off the ground. Toe of the club is supposed to be off the ground, because as I stop coming down and start going back up again on the other side, all the G forces in my swing are pulling down on the toe of the club, and this club is going to come and sit itself down, and that's going to bow the shaft forward. This is a very stiff golf shaft, right? So notice how much bend there is in there. So there's a lot going on in the golf swing. So I've got my solid grip. Posture, notice how that brings my posture down as well. I'm getting ready to collect the ball from the ground, so I want the sole of the club to peel the grass along the surface of the ground. That's what's going to put the ball on the club face. I'm not getting ready to slap the ball. I'm getting ready to deliver grass in the direction of the target. So notice my posture now, because I have a sound grip, it's going to relate to a better posture dynamically. And now all I got to do is gather and release that club out there. Hear the sound of that sucker? Woo, that's fun. That's 190, that flag stick. And I got 7 in my hands. 7 iron. I'm 56 years old. And I'm certainly not a gym rat. That was 187 carry. Okay? So this is how you get compression. When you're able to compress the ball is going to come off the face with a lot more speed. So we look at the efficiency, that was 1.38, right? So almost 1.4. I was able to transfer a lot of compression from my body through the club face into the golf ball. And my ball speed on that was 130 miles an hour, okay? So I hope you enjoyed and appreciated what a solid lead hand grip is going to do for you. As far as the trail hand grip is concerned, in the meantime, go see a video, an oldie but goodie of mine, called Knife the Grip, Shawn Clement. And on our premium channel, you'll see grip. You go down our list of videos by date. Toward the bottom is Fundamental City, and that includes the grip. So you see grip and grip part 2, which is the trail hand. Enjoy that, you guys. Can't wait to see you next week. All the best.